Welcome to Soul Cafe Radio, where we cater food for the mind and soul. Please join us this hour for uplifting music, messages, and more. And now to the RMG Studios in Miami Gardens, Florida, and your host, the Word Master.
Hello friends, welcome to Soul Cafe Radio for December 1st, 2021. We are in the home stretch of this year. And as usual, on our first Wednesdays, it is customary that we do a period of praise and worship and have a few moments for our lesson at the end of that time. So today, that's exactly what we're going to be doing. We're going to be having the first half hour of songs of praise. And so I invite you to join me as we just reflect upon the goodness of the Lord this hour. Our theme for the next 4 days is based in the book of Philippians. We'll be looking at lessons from the book of Philippians. And our four verses under consideration are Philippians 1, verse 6 today, Philippians 2, 13, 3, 13, and 4, 13. Let me read the scripture for today before I pray. It says, Philippians 1, 6, being confident of this very thing, that he which hath begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for being with us today. I pray, Lord God, that as we come into the Soul Cafe period, that your people will indeed find nourishment for the mind and soul. I pray, Lord God, that they will be tremendously blessed, that the music that will be paramount this half hour will be a blessing, O Lord God. I pray your mercies, I pray your goodness, I pray your love upon this session in the almighty, wonderful name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
You're listening to Soul Cafe Radio, food for the mind and soul.
This lonely pilgrim land, raising strong and mighty fortresses, and I alone command. With these castles I've constructed by the strength of my own hand, are just temporary kingdoms on foundations made of sand. In the middle of the battle, I'm accomplishments are worthless and not see. He will make a way for me. He will be my guide. Hold me closely to His side. With love and strength for each new day, He will make a way. He will make a see. He will make a way for me. He will be my guide. Hold me closely to His side. With love and strength for each new day, He will make a way. He will make a way. By a roadway in the
You're listening to Soul Cafe Radio, food for the mind and soul.
I'll light them in with
If you just joined us, we are in the midst of our first Wednesday praise and worship session, and we have a ways to go. But remember also that this is the first day of our brand new series, the Philippian study. We're looking at Philippians 1 and verse 6 today. We'll be spending a few minutes looking at it towards the end of the program. The bulk of today, as we'll do on every first Wednesday, is to play a portion of more of the hour with music, just so that you have at least one day of the week where you are lifted up, and we'll try to play a variety of songs that uplift the spirit. Again, you're listening to Soul Cafe Radio, and this is what we do here on this program. It is indeed food for the mind and soul.
Please take a few seconds to support the channel. See the info in the description.
I will come into your presence. lift him up tonight.
Tonight on Soul Cafe TV, we'll be premiering a special entitled Grace Training. Grace Training, Running with Patience. If you have not subscribed to the channel, please go over and do so. SoulCafeTV.us, SoulCafeTV.us, or go over to YouTube and search out Soul Cafe TV and subscribe. I promise you, you do not want to miss this very important presentation. Again, tonight at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, we premiere Grace Training, Running with Patience. You don't want to miss that, I promise you. SoulCafeTV.us.
You're listening to Soul Cafe Radio, food for the mind and soul.
Please take a few seconds to support the channel. See the info in the description.
I know somebody who cares. He's got it made. He won't admit it, but
but it's just a masquerade. He's a modern day deceiver with a case of falsehood fever. What a shame. It's a game. And then there's a dear old sister Sarah, and she's sweet.
Oh, yes, she is.
She gets the word next thing you know. It's in the street. By the time it's been repeated, all the truth has been deleted. Oh, what a shame. Another game. Seems like everything we hear is just a tale. I've got something that would never, ever fail. It's gonna
spread love.
Oh, it's gonna spread tonight.
Spread love.
The truth is in the sky. I've often said love could open any door. Oh, but I wish we had much more.
More love is what we need. Da, 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 da.
They have subscriptions to the gossip magazine. With a twisted sense of vision, they treat rumors like religion. What a shame. It's the same old well, these days it seems like everything we hear is just a tale. I believe in something that will never fail.
Just as important as the resurrection is to the Christian experience, so too are the words of our scripture reading for this evening as we begin the Galatians series. being confident of this very thing, that he which hath begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. Today we want to celebrate another theme, and that theme is what Christ, because of the merits of that resurrection power, is able to do inside of you. Again, Philippians 1:6 says, being confident of this very thing, that he which hath begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. Just having come off of our No Excuses series, it is very clear that we have a lot and a long way to go, because we still make excuses and we still give license to sin. But as our opening song just said, we need to celebrate Christ's resurrection power. We need to realize without a shadow of a doubt, dear listener, that what we have at our disposal is almighty power. Notice the words, being confident of this very thing. Confidence, friends. And I want you to notice that who the Apostle Paul is addressing. He's addressing his Philippian audience. He's not letting them know that I'm confident that the God who began a good work in me is able to perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. He's encouraging the Philippian brethren. He's encouraging you, dear listener, that what he began, he's able to accomplish. He's able to finish. Friends, this is a sad irony of our times, because you see, friends, as we talked about in the No Excuses series, many persons are of the belief that God, yes, he saved us, he delivered us, he washed us, he redeemed us, and all that good stuff. But right now, he's not able to take us through. He's not able to carry us through. And so he says, make it on your own. Friends, that could not be further from the truth. Notice what the Bible is clear of. It says that he began the work and he is going to be able to perform it. The apostle is confident, being confident of this very thing, that he which hath begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. But you see, friends, the thing is, we have to allow him to finish the work. We have to allow him to do what he says that he will do. All throughout these 4 days, we'll be looking at this theme of perseverance, endurance, but most importantly, what God can do through us. It is a prayer of my heart, dear listener, and from my heart to yours, I truly want you to understand that we don't have to make any excuses for sins anymore. We should be done with all of that, because as you see here, the work is not ours. During the series, I talked about persons who would have had lost hope, lost confidence in God, and they would have given up on the process. And many of them, many such persons, one I know in particular I've heard of, who would have taken his life because he could not endure the race. Oh, my friends, the Bible is clear. It takes endurance, friends. It takes endurance. But here in Philippians 1, verse 6, as we begin the Philippians series, understand, my dear listeners, understand that the work is altogether God's work. What takes endurance on your part is to allow the process to play out. Yes, friends, yes. We don't have to sugarcoat it, because God knows what he's doing, and he's confident, as the Apostle Paul is confident, that he is able to carry you through. The thing is, friends, yes, we know that sometimes God works like he is made of molasses, very slow. But you see, that's what makes it even better. Because as we know, he still working on us. He's taking his time with us to make us what we ought to be. And we should allow the process to take place, to play itself out. We need not step in front of God and hinder the process. We need to realize that He will be able to carry us through. We need to understand, dearly beloved, that our God is able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we can ask or think, according to every purpose that works in us. Do you dare to believe, my friends? Do you dare to believe that God, my friends, it's a beautiful thing that we can trust a God who hasn't brought us this far and then is not able to carry us through.
Said I wouldn't fall. Never said that it would go the way I wanted to go. But when my back is against the wall and I feel all hope is gone, I lift my hands up to the sky and say, help me to be
That last line is what the Apostle Paul was telling the Philippian brethren, that God had not brought them this far to leave them. He was very confident that the God that he served was able to carry them through. My listeners, I know that 2021 has been rough. It rivaled 2020 in comparison. But here, at the home stretch, I know my God is able to carry you through. In fact, stay with us as we will close out with that very song. But in these final few minutes, I want to appeal to your heart. I want you to truly understand, dear listener, that as the word says, he which hath begun a good work in you will perform that same good work until the day that Christ comes to claim you as his own. Would you believe that for me? Would you believe that with me today? I challenge you, dear listener, that as you listen, that you will understand that the word of God is clear. He loves you. He's patiently working with you to accomplish all that he said that he would do. And friends, here's the sticking point. When you really can't trace his hand, trust his heart. Know that as a father, as any earthly father, he's got you. He is very near and very dear to you. Oh, my brother, my sister, understand that the God of the universe has special interest in you today. He has not forgotten you. It may seem that way. You may have suffered loss. You may have suffered so much. But I want you to understand that indeed and in truth that the Lord hasn't brought you this far to leave you. We talked about the children of Israel leaving Egypt and having their first confrontation in the wilderness with doubt, anxiety, and fear. The God whom they served was able to deliver them, as he said, with a strong arm. They didn't have to lift a finger to work with him in their deliverance. And here they are, meeting their first major obstacle, and they begin to buckle. The Lord would have us understand that in these final days of Earth's history, we will have many obstacles to cross over. But the Lord, our Savior, has already trod this way before us, and he only bids us, follow me. Follow me. My brother, my sister, God is well able to take you from where he took you into where he'll have you. And that is spending the ceaseless ages of eternity with him. Do you trust him today? Do you believe him today? Do you take him at his word today? It is a prayer in my heart that you do. May God bless you abundantly as you contemplate these things. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for your loving kindness and your tender mercies towards us. Thank you for being to us a God like no other. We love you and praise you. And we give you all the praise, honor, and glory that you deserve, we pray. In Jesus Christ's name, amen. Thank you, dear listener, for joining us today here on Soul Cafe Radio. We truly do appreciate you. And as we begin this final month of 2021, by God's grace, we'll finish strong. We'll finish on a super high note. We'll finish very, very uplifting. May God bless you abundantly as you contemplate that he hasn't brought you this far to leave you. And in fact, let's end today's program on a high note, knowing that not only is he leading you in the moments that you so desperately need it, he will carry you through. God bless.
There is no problem too big God cannot solve it. There is no mountain too tall He cannot move it. There is no storm too dark God cannot calm it. There is no
sorrow too deep, he cannot soothe it. If he carried the weight of the world upon his shoulders, I know, my brother, that he will carry you. If he carried the weight of the world upon his shoulders, I know, my sister, that he will carry you. He said, come unto me, all who are weary, and I will give you rest. There is no problem too big that God cannot solve it. There is no mountain too tall, he cannot move it. There is no storm too dark, God cannot calm it. There is no sorrow too deep, he cannot soothe it. If he carried the weight of the world upon his shoulders, I know, my brother, that he will carry you. If he carried the weight of the world upon his shoulders, I know, my sister, that he will carry you. If he carried the weight of the world upon his shoulders, I know, my brother, that he will carry you.
Thank you for joining us today on Soul Cafe Radio. You've been listening to powerful music and messages for the mind and soul. Join us next time when we deliver more of the same. And remember to visit our website at www.soulcafeonline.org.